الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يأتكم مثل الذين خلوا من قبلكم مستهم البأساء والضراء وزلزلوا حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه متى نصر الله الا ان نصر الله قريب صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم اما بعد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقده من لساني يفقهوا قولي My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today is Jummah, and inshallah, this is the first of a series of lectures that we plan to upload at least on a weekly basis, and maybe more frequently if you do feel it is appropriate and if it is helping our brothers and sisters who, for practical purposes, are quarantined and remain at home, unable to pray Jummah, unable to connect, unable to come to the masjid, because all these are part of a Muslim's life. It's almost like being as a fish out of water, and it behoves us to stand together and try to strengthen each other in a time of crisis like this. And while everybody is talking about coronavirus and the calamity that has come, and the question comes, why us, why now, why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put us in difficulties, so on and so forth, I chose this first ayah, which is from Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 214. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks the believers, Am hasibtum an tadkhulul jannah? Do you think you're going to enter Jannah straight without any kind of incidents that would come to you? Just like people before you, وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ People before you have gone through difficulties. مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا They were afflicted with all kinds of adversities, reached them. They were badly shaken, وَزُلْزِلُوا حَتَّى Until يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ People, the Prophet himself at that time, and the people with him, they asked, مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهُ When will Allah's help come? And Allah says, Behold, Ala inna nasra Allahi qareeb. The help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come. It is very close. Be patient. You need to practice patience. And this is the reality. In other words, we are living in this dunya. This is not Jannah. This is a place where calamities can happen. This is a place where you will have difficulties come. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has left this as a testing ground as to how my servants are going to face this and how they're going to respond. We have on one extreme where people, when they come through this extreme, they say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not here. If Allah was here, He would have protected me. If Allah was there, He would have saved me. So I have lost my faith, anauzubillah. Then there are people, the real believers, for them, their iman increases. They go through a period of patience, and that is beneficial for him. And the world today is in a big mess. And there is no need to go into details. We all know what's happening all over the world. The zulm, the oppression that is taking place in different parts of the world. And sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends these kind of calamities as a response so that people may turn back. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Sajda, وَلَنُزِيقَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَدْنَى دُونَ الْعَذَابِ الْأَكْبَرِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ And surely, we will make them taste some of the nearer torments before the big torment that is going to come, so that one who sees it may hope that just now they will turn back repenting. And if previous nations serve as an example for us, as a lesson for us, the Quran is replete. So many examples Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives. And one of the most glaring examples that comes is, again, in the Quran, in Surah Al-A'raf, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the story of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam when he faces Fir'aun. When he went with obvious signs, clear signs, وَلَمَّا جَاءَهُمْ جَاءَهُمُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ عِنْدِنَا truth from us, قَالُ اقْتُلُوا أَبْنَاءَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعْهُ وَاسْتَحْيُوا نِسَاءَهُمْ Fir'aun became more obstinate, more arrogant, and he said, you want to show this? Let's go and kill all their children, especially kill their boys, the male children, and leave their women alone, meaning leave their female infants alone. In other words, to make them more, to weaken them. And this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَيْدُ الْكَافِرِينَ إِلَّا فِي ضَلَالٍ The kafir tries hard to put down the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to try to disprove Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's ayat, but always it goes in vain. And again, coming back to the people of Fir'aun, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ أَقَذْنَا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ بِالسِّنِينَ وَنَقْسِمْ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ We seize the people of Fir'aun with years of dearth, with scarcity of fruits, so that they may listen to the dhikr that has been sent, the admonitions that have been sent. But فَإِذَا جَاتْهُمُ الْحَسَنَةُ قَالُوا لَنَا هَذِهِ When anything good came, they would say, this is for us. We expect this because it is our work. وَإِن تُصِبْهُمْ سَيِّئَةٌ يَتَّيَّرُ بِمُوسَى وَمَنْ مَعَهُ But then, when some evil comes, they would point towards the Muslims, point towards Musa alayhi salatu wasalam and his people. And they would say, this is all because of them. Allah, behold, إِنَّمَا تُعِرُهُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ The real truth is, the bad fortune that is falling them, it's from Allah. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ Most people don't understand this. I want you to pause for a moment. Let us think of the Uyghurs in China, the way they have been persecuted, because all they did was try to follow Islam, and the Chinese feel it is un-Chinese for them to do that. So they're being forced so that they're retrained not to do wudu, retrained not to pray or salah in congregation, retrained not to practice saum because they feel that it reduces productivity, anawzubillah. And this is somewhat a similar situation. And we need to kind of look at the Quran's ayat in this light. Whenever calamities came, even the people of Fir'aun, they would bog down. They would bow down. And then they would say, وَقَالُوا مَهْمَا تَأْتِنَا بِهِ مِنْ آيَةٍ لِتَسْحَرَنَا بِهَا فَمَا نَحْنُ لَكَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ Whatever the nature of a sign you may bring us to enchant us, we are not going to believe you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent more calamities. فَأَرْسَلْنَا عَلَيْهِمُ الطُّوفَانَ وَالْجَرَادَ وَالْقُمَّلَ وَالدَّفَادِيَ وَالدَّمَ آيَاتٍ مُفَصَّلَاتٍ فَاسْتَكْبَرُوا وَكَانُوا قَوْمًا مُجْرِمِينَ So Allah sent them floods, He sent them locusts, He sent them lice and frogs and blood, clear signs. But they were a group of sinful people who would not bend down. Whenever difficulties would come, they would tell Musa, if you take this calamity out, you pray to Allah, you tell your Rabb to take this off and we'll believe you. But when that calamity would go, they would get back to what they were doing. My dear brothers, today the world has become a playing field for rich countries to play. And the poor people are the ones who are taking the brunt. Today Syria has become a playing field. And you can see the millions of migrants that are swarming into Turkey, into Europe. And these people have nothing to do with what's happening, but they're the ones who are taking the brunt. I want you to consider this in the light of this calamity. The truth is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has power over everything. And He can use anything that we know not. He has power, His armies are there and we have no idea. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. And the armies of Allah, no one knows but Him. Today a simple virus has brought the world to its knees. Young and old, rich and poor, all are affected. And when calamities come, they don't discriminate. They don't discriminate between people, good or bad. And the Quran testifies to this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّقُوا fear, فِتْنَةً لَا تُسِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاسَّةً. Fear the fitna when it comes. It doesn't come to a particular core group in particular. It just comes in general. So everyone gets affected. When zunub increase, realize and expect that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to be happy. And it is time for the Muslim Ummah to do introspection. Ask each one, what is wrong? What can I do to change this? During the time of Hadrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, there was a famine. And he effectively took hold of it. He personally supervised the distribution of food. He tried to delay the taxes. And he joined people in prayer, in making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve them from the famine. My dear brothers, for every disease, there is a remedy, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said. And there is a remedy for a calamity as well. Again, like I said, it is time for deep introspection. There is a physical remedy, there is a spiritual remedy. Unfortunately, we have become one-eyed. We are talking about the physical aspect of it. There is tons in the social media, how to clean your hands, how to wash your mouth, how to disinfect your house, how to disinfect your clothes, which all is true. Social distancing, yes, please do practice it. I'm not against it. That part is essential, but what we are missing is the spiritual aspect. My dear brothers, when was the last time we engaged in the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Today, everybody is anxious. My friends are coming and telling me, I'm so anxious, I'm so uneasy. My blood pressure is going up. And I'm sure you can relate to it. It's a time for anxiety. Even if you have not been afflicted, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you from the virus. But even if you're not, that anxiety remains. My children, my family, what will happen to them? And outside in the third world countries, it's worse because there's no food to eat. Even worse, people are dying of hunger more so than dying from the virus. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. So number one, dhikrullah. And why do I say this? The Quran states, Ala inna dhikrullahi tatma'innul qulub. Behold, in the remembrance of Allah is where you're going to find peace for your heart. Number two, practice forgiveness. Ask forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again and again. Number three, try to wake up for tahajjud and ask for forgiveness again. Because when you ask for forgiveness, my dear brothers, the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down. In fact, in Surah Anfal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses one of the taunts of the disbelievers. When the disbelievers mock at Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say, if you're really a true prophet, and if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really sent you down, why don't you ask Allah to send down the adab here? And the answer comes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not chastise them, will not send the adab when you are among them. And Allah adds, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not send punishment when they're begging for forgiveness. So this is a reminder, my dear brothers, for you and for me. Let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He protect us from this calamity. Allahumma hafizna min kulli balai dunya wa azab al-akhirah. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna tiba'a. Wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna jtinaba. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina maulana Muhammad wa ala ala sayyidina Muhammad wa barik wa sallim. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat wal muslimina wal muslimat. Al-ahyai minhum wal amwat. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولصحاب الأجمعين.